Yeah, that's all right, isn't it?
Well, I'll tell you what I was talking
about. Sorry.
It's all right.
Where do you give up the water?
I see you've spotted it, Darren.
Tonight, it's a celebration of the 60th anniversary of a school being on this site in Buttershaw. The school was opened on 3rd of September 1956 to 300 pupils and 15 staff and an headmaster and a cleaner. And on that day, I was one of the first pupils here. The first school cost £250,000, and then it had some extensions in 1964 to make it into a comprehensive, which cost an extra £300,000. And then they built this school, and it cost £28 million.
Hey, how are you doing? How are you doing? I like you to think
you're having a little bit of physics and trying a glass.
Mind you, I'm not big on car.
No, no.
Is he...
Did you find yourself on the wrist
one? Oh my gosh.
Where is it?
Squeeze it, people, so we can get the food in.
Right, right guys.
Should I move that to one side? I'll leave it on that.
Ready? 1, 2, 3.
That looks fantastic.
That's brilliant, thank you.
Who did the cake then?
Is that an
outside cake?
I
like the cake because that's the one that Sandra designed on. You want Sandra Hirst, head of art, did that one. That's the original.
That's the thing, should be on here. She was in the car, wasn't it?
That must be one of you.
Oh, it's going to Paris though. Hey, they went to Paris.
Can I have any of that?
That's more enjoyable. These all went to Paris, look at these. They're amazing.
So what you're telling me is the interaction with space is not so much as we interact with space.
I can't believe that.
Gemma Walter, chair the beam, and Sarah Goster
here. You looking at me?
Oh my goodness.
Look at the pictures. Now I've seen somebody in here that I recognise.
Have you?
No, I mean, isn't it?
I can't remember. Who's that?
I don't know.
Hello, it's
Steve. Is that Mr. Smith?
I left in 63.
You knew I was coming.
That's yeah, that's it.
You knew the old. Can't believe it. So different.
Yeah. Yeah. So it's
brand new. Yeah.
It's really fun. It's really fun.
Catherine Ball, I know we've
just run up
maybe something else not feed up.
Yeah, I brought some stuff for your museum.
Oh, brilliant! You should be able to find yourself somewhere down there.
I bought some stuff.
I asked if she's going to get me a bath.
Did you buy it?
I probably hooked somebody.
I was there.
The children.
Yeah, this is the main atrium, so we have that many students, we have got several sections in here.
To serve all the meals in this area?
Yeah. Not all at the same time, because we've got 60 minutes, so we're stacking the lunches now.
Thank you.
Management of the scissors so that we get a before and after shot. There we go. I declare this mural official.
Don't all rush at once.
Oh, right.
Okay. We can have a look.
We thought you were going to make a speech.
No. That comes later.
Let's do the old one. I think we're on the left.
Oh, oh, oh,
Adrian.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. There you are.
We both the trish.
Found your ball.
Mr. Oh, Pickers, oh, yeah.
Yeah, look, can you see Adrian?
Typical of me to notice that, isn't it?
Oh, right, okay.
I'm there, put an E in it, look. I've spelt my name wrong.
Jonathan? Oh, yes, they have.
Yeah.
Big off in space.
Seven for an hour.
Yeah.
We gotta do all the mixing in the
That's
what he told us, but
I'm Peter Pan.
Oh yes. Yeah. Walk it down low.
Yeah, I've been asked to build one many times.
Yeah, amazing.
Oh yeah, you mean that is the
Thank you.
Thank you. It's going to count down, 3, 2, 1. My Lord Mayor, His Lady Mayoress, friends of the school, former students, present students, governors, former staff, present staff, possibly the worst person to ask to do this. Because as a relative newbie to the school, the head had a secret weapon. Adrian Hartshorn. He put me... quiet, and as the student body enjoys its weekend, we felt it would be important for you to see what a day looks like with 14
trustful ancestor values. You think our experience will be invaluable. Already, the schools have been working together and asked them to help. Student investigators have been visiting.
Mr. Richard Hughes.
It's like today. I mean, obviously, it's a shame, as Tony said, that you can't come and see it. When we've got all the students. I wanted to say just a couple of things, really. I wanted to give you an image, but before you then got all the other schools that we work with. So the numbers of schools that are providing us with. Actually, we'd love it if you come back and talk to some of our current students about what you're currently doing. That would be fantastic. Thank you.
This would not be complete unless I hand over to so, first to our singers, it's a big fat yes from me. Guys tonight, haven't we? It's absolutely wonderful, isn't it? Mr. Hughes. Fantastic. Also like to thank Mr. McCambridge over there. And Mr. Haig, is Mr. Haig here? And also Mr. Neil Beattie, who did Expo. This has been an absolutely wonderful night. It's just, as I say, I feel as though I'm back in school. Because I used to wear glasses. So Mr. Allen noticed that I had some pretty good organisation skills.
He's so, on purpose.
What he got me doing... So, I went and stuck posters up all over the school. And I'm still sticking the posters up. You've seen it, haven't you? Out there, in the hallway. Mr. Cook, the head teacher, was a fellow of the Royal Graphical Society. Thank you for a wonderful evening tonight. Absolutely fantastic. And I hope to see you.
Just for a minute, what that story is that commenced, probably on mine. Why is it that I believe that every single child can achieve something? Where did I get that from? I got it from Buttershaw, actually. Learning achievement is very important. Of course it is. But even more important is the qualities that we have.
In 2008, he is awarded by Her Majesty the Queen the CBE for his services to education. Wow. Neil Expo Creative, who patiently digitally stitched together the timeline wall art we've all seen this evening.
Still. All right. I knew Glenda was.
We did a table of 10.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to part two of the celebration of Buttershaw School Diamond Jubilee.
Kick around.
No, we've met.
Did you go to Marley School?
Oh, yeah.
That was on the end of my lane.
Who's a tall one?
Yes.
Lady Maris, if you go, that's my wife. Yeah.
Then after another short break, we then have a cabaret. Don't be hearing, you've not seen me yet. I myself will not be joining in because I did pass my 11 plus and I went to Grange Grammar. I'm only joking. Okay, let's move on to the interesting part for me. The first one to the fundraiser.
One by one we were called out to the front and we met our teacher. So I was called out, leaving arms which we lived to regret for many years. One year the boys tried to tunnel through from behind a cabin. But the real question is, how has our days at Buttershaw affected our lives going on from there? So Trish is going to talk about how it's affected hers, and then she's going to pass back to me and I'll do a little bit more, then we finish.
I didn't start till 1973, so they were there before I was, and then after I'd left, after they were in the theatre was an amazing theatre, an amazing place. Stories and escaping, we were brought up in Buttershaw, Ribsy, some of them. And so we were just allowed.
The same English teacher inspired me to go on reading after, long after leaving school. We studied Wuthering Heights by Emily Bronte, we did the First World War poets, Siegfried Sassoon, and I think Wilfred Owen, I think it might have been. And A Man for All Seasons by Robert Bolt, which is a play that my husband, for the last 2 years, I've managed to organise the class of 78 reunion here at this hotel, and brought upwards of 65, 70 of us back together. So that's what Buttershaw did, and I thank it. I love my time.
Please bless you. To keep hold of the past, and obviously then pass the baton on to somebody who will carry on now. Ladies and gentlemen, can I please introduce to you...
...feedback is going over the next few years. So whenever I teach a lesson, and whenever I do something like this, the fun bit really, who became a man, William Shatner, was a woman in the pilot show, but the producers, or the called John Elfrith Williams, and he was an American, and in 1900 he predicted, in 2000, photographs will be telegraphed from any distance. It was dealing with the issues of the present, and fundamentally there were issues about how...
It's a wonderful thing to remember our school days, and included some social history regarding Buttershaw, the school, and hopefully he will find
it. Yeah.
School. Yes. The teachers were good to save up for their children to go. But we did not know anything different, and we were happy with what we had. And the calculator was an abacus. And with it was an
Those of you over 40 can chase him around. Is that correct? Okay. Do you like impressions? Woohoo! During the production, one of Paul's jobs.
Hello, sir.
Okay. What flavour is it? Strong. Thank you very much. Thank you. Pupils, young and old. Last night, myself and many people went back to school. And what a school I found, a grand edifice. A phoenix had arisen, who has made... Oh, who's my boss? very night at the races, a visit to the cinema, even a trip. We have now found. One more time, please, Paul Ayrhurst.
Of course you can, sir.
Thank you. Gift that might just help you remember us.
Right, thank you. Thank you. Going to speak to you. It's all worthwhile. I know a lot of, and we've been clicking ever since. because you know, we've retired, and when we meet the second Tuesday,
yeah. And you can fill.
Thank you. Enjoy yourself. I'll let you back to Dennis. Thank you, guys. Thank you.
Yeah. One more time, please. The three tenors.
Completely, or I'll never give my heart. And the moment I see you, like
3 years, probably
thank you.
Yeah, we put it back in for us again, so we can get another shot.
Oh.
Keep holding in. There we go for it. One.
Yeah.